गुड आफ्टरनून सर, नाय गुड सर, आर यू देयर सर? नागेगौड़ सर, सर काइंडली अनम्यूट युअर सेल्फ सर। नागेगौड़ सर,
ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲಲ್ಲ
ಸರ್. ಗುಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ನೂನ್ ಸರ್, ನಾಗೇ ಕೂಡ ಸರ್, ಎಂ ಐ ಆಡಿಬಲ್ ಸರ್?
ಸರ್ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ?
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್, ನೌ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಡಿಬಲ್ ಸರ್.
ನೌ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಡಿಬಲ್ ಆ?
ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಸರ್, ಎಸ್ ಸರ್, ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಹಾಂ, ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ
ಓಕೆ. ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ನೂನ್ ಟು ಎವರಿ ಒನ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ಟು ದಿ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ನೂನ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಡೇ. ನೌ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವಿತ್ ಅಸ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ನಾಗೇಗೌಡ NS, who is Assistant Chief Technical Officer, Vegetable Crops, Indian Institute of Horticulture Research, ICAR, IIHR, Bangalore. Sir is who is going to deliver a talk on recent advances in vegetable seed production. It gives me an immense pleasure to introduce Dr. Nagegowda NS, who has completed his PhD in agronomy and who has joined as a technical officer during 2010 at ICAR IIHR Division of Vegetable Crops, Bangalore. During his PhD studies, he has taken up a study on fertigation and seed improvement studies in okra, and it is very special to mention that sir is having 10 years of experience in the breeder and truthful labeled seed production and its maintenance in vegetable crops. And in addition to that, sir is having a credit of around more than 15 papers who are been published in different NAS rated journals. I think we are very fortunate to have such a vast experienced person in vegetable seed production with us. Now I would like to request Dr. Nagegowda NS to take up this session and deliver his lecture on vegetable recent advances in vegetable seed production. Over to you, sir. Nagegowda sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your nice introduction. So, good afternoon, all of you. Can you hear me? Everything?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Go ahead, sir. Please.
Okay. Good afternoon, all of you. So, today my topic is on about advanced seed production technology in vegetable crops. Okay. So just I am going to brief about how to do quality seed production in vegetable crops. So I am going to present. So what are the important crops? I am divided into two categories. One is open pollinated seed production. Second one is hybrid seed production technology. In open, how to do open seed production in open pollinated varieties and also in hybrid seed production. So earlier what you are going to do in age old practices, how seed production was carried out. So they usually what you are going to do is you select very good plants. In that, very good fruits are selected. So from that you are using those seeds for crop production. Nowadays what happened, because of introduction of breeders, advanced method of breeder techniques, so you have so many new varieties which are resistant to disease, which are resistant to pest, which are giving high yielding varieties. So this is one of the method we can increase our yield levels, okay, through advanced breeding techniques. Second one is, nowadays farmers are buying vegetable seeds in loose without labeling anything. So this is one of the problem are facing by the farmers. Then how to know this is which is the good quality seeds? So how to get true to type seed material? So I'm going to present in this session. Just I will share my screens with the different slides what I am going to present. Can everyone can see my slides? Yeah. So this is advanced seed production technology in vegetable crops. So before that, I'm going to what are the important points to be considered while taking the seed production in vegetable crops. So first, what is the meaning of seeds? Seeds refers to the fertilized or matured ovum. That means that contains embryonic plants, stored material and protective coats. That itself we can call it as a seeds. What is the difference between seed and grain? So grain means you will not find any matured ovule. Sometimes there is a matured ovule will be there or immature ovule will be there. That it will not sufficient for germination. So that is called as a seed. Seed refers to the fertilized matured ovule. So what is the role of seed? So there is a four roles I pointed out. One first role is, you see, that is a carrier of new technology. Any technology can be assessed through you have to use good quality of seeds.
Screen scale mode, sir, please.
Pardon?
Enlarge, sir, please.
This is even required enlargement.
Okay. Slide show, madi, sir. Slide show.
Okay, got it. Okay. Okay. Right. Is it okay now?
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Fine.
Okay. So what is the role of seeds? Role of seed is important. I pointed out four points in role of seeds. One of the important role is a carrier of new technology. So if you have developed any new technology, so you have to take a good quality of seeds, then only you can get good results. One of the carrier of new technology. Seeds plays important role here. Second one is, seed is one of the basic input that itself secured it good supply. Third one is, during the less favorable area, during drought period, it can these seeds plays an important role here. The third role is, in case of natural disaster like heavy flood, seeds plays important role for rapid rehabilitation in agriculture. Okay, these are the important role in role of seeds. So what are the advantages of high quality seeds? So high quality seeds nothing but a genetically pure seeds. Genetically pure seeds nothing but a true to type seeds. So what is the advantage of using high quality seeds means you will get high returns per unit area. So third advantage is it has a, you will get, it has a less infestation of the land with weed seeds and other crops. If you get good quality seed means, so you didn't find any weed seeds or other crop seeds, so that there is a less infestation of the land. That fourth advantage is less disease and insect problem. So thus, if you get good quality of seeds means you must have a less disease and insect problem. If you use a very good quality seeds means you'll respond to the applied fertilizer and nutrients. So then good seed prolongs the life of the variety. If you use very good quality of seeds means you can our seed that life of the variety can prolong. So like this crop price pardon sir. Okay, so I produce value and you can if you use the good quality of seeds, the marketability of the produce you can improve with the help of the high quality seeds. So I told you earlier, so a good quality of seeds nothing but, so the if there is a fourth, you have to consider five important factor. So one, if the seed material should be genetically pure. So genetically pure nothing but it is a true to type. So second important quality, good quality parameter means it should be a physically pure. Third important factor is physiologically viable. And fourth factor is it should be free from weed and other crop seeds. Fifth factor is free from designated diseases. I'm going to explain each and every how to get genetically pure seeds or true to type seeds one by one. So production of genetically pure, how you are going to produce genetically pure seeds? So it requires high level of technical skills is required. So second one is you have to monitor, strict monitoring is required for the production program and execution of all required operation in time with either water management, whether it is a nutrient management, whether it is a weed management.
Obviously.
You have to follow in time so that you will get very good seeds. So how to maintenance of genetic purity, what are the steps involved in the maintenance of the genetic purity of the seeds? There are six steps you have to follow in order to get genetic purity of the seeds. First is control over the seed source. So basically you have to take very good quality of seeds during, that is main important. Second one is the preceding of the crop requirement. Suppose if you have grown last year crop is same, should not be next crop should not be same. That is a preceding of the crop requirement is also very important in order to maintain the genetic purity of the crop. Second one is the second and third most important factor is isolation requirement. For each and every crop there is a isolation requirement you have to follow in order to get the purity of the seeds. Third and fourth important factor is roguing operations. Roguing operation means removal of haplotype in the seed plots. That is important operation for maintaining of the genetic purity of the crop. Fifth operation is you have to get the certification from the authorized certification agency, seed certification agency. And sixth important steps is a grow out test. After completion of the seed production, you have to go for the test, that is a grow out test, whether the given seed lot is maintained our purity or not. So in that you can test through grow out test. So this is the first important, this is the first step, control over the seed source. How to seeds you have to take, there is use the use of different seeds of appropriate class. There is a different classes of seeds are available in India. So one is nucleus seeds, second one is foundation seeds, third one is a certified seeds. So for you have to take these seed as a further multiplication. So what is a nucleus seeds? Where it you are going to maintain these nucleus seeds? That is an important factor. So nucleus seeds is produced and maintained by the breeder. Suppose and our institute concerned. Suppose if the breeder has developed one variety, means he has to you will maintain the breeder seeds, or that institute is responsible for the production of that nucleus seed. Second is the breeder seeds. Breeder seeds nothing but it is a produced under the direct supervision with the help of the breeder, and it is a progeny of what of the nucleus seed. So how you are distinguish from the one class of the seed to the next means by the color of the tag. If the color of the tag is yellow, means you can definitely tell so breeder seeds. Second category is foundation seeds. How we are going to produce these foundation means this is a progeny of the breeder seeds and supervised by the seed certification authorities like National Seed Corporation is there, or state seed certification agency. They will follow these foundation seed production. So we are distinguished this seed material means with the help of tag color, that is a white color tag. Third category of the seed is certified seeds. This is a progeny of the foundation seeds and produced under supervision of the certification agency. These seeds supply to the progressive farmer. So it how you means marked with blue color tag. Second important step for the purity of genetic purity is preceding of crop requirement and isolation distance. So in order to avoid the contamination of the variety or due to voluntary plants, you have to maintain proper isolation distance. Isolation distance nothing but the you have to maintain minimum distance between the two varieties so that they can avoid the contamination between the two variety. So in order to improve the in order to achieve can the genetic purity. So I have given this table. What are the different type of minimum isolation distance followed in the foundation seeds and also in the certified seeds. Suppose if your variety is tomato, means that is a self pollinated varieties, you have to maintain. So one variety, if you have two variety, means you have to maintain 50 meter distance. For if your class of seed production is foundation, means you have to maintain 15 meter. Suppose if your class of certified seed, means you have to maintain 25 meter. So similarly, so hybrid seed production, you have to 200 meter is required for foundation seed production, and also 100 meter is required for certified seeds. So okra is a often cross pollinated varieties. So it required 400 meter minimum isolation is required is 400 meter for foundation and certified 200 meter. Similarly, brinjal requires 400 capsicum and chili is required 400 meters for foundation seed production and 200 meter for certified seed production. And regarding with brinjal varieties, both hybrid and say 200 meter is required for foundation, and OP certified seeds of OP varieties is 100 meter is required, and brinjal is 200 meter is meter is required for isolation distance. Regarding with the legumes, so legumes means all French bean, cowpea, then yardlang bean. So all legumes, it requires a minimum of 10 meter, very less. This is only self-pollinated crops. It require very less distance for foundation seed production, and also 5 meter is required for certified. So regarding cucurbits is nothing but cross-pollinated varieties. All cross-pollinated varieties required minimum of 1 kilometer to 1.5 kilometer is required for production of any foundation or certified seeds. Like similar seeds, cucurbit varieties is required 1000 meter, 1000 means 1 kilometer is required. for foundation seeds and 0.5 km is required for certified seeds. Similarly, cucurbit hybrids. So a little bit higher is isolation is required for 1.5 km for foundation seeds and certified seeds 1000 meters. So similarly, this is also onion is also cross pollinated crop. It also require 1 km isolation distance in order to avoid the contamination with the other crop varieties. Similarly, radish also all cross pollinated varieties, what I told now. So 1 km to 1.5 km is required for isolation, meter is required for isolation distance. Regarding amaranthus, asparagus and lettuce is required 0.5 km for foundation seeds and certified seeds is 200 to 300 meter is required for isolation distance. So this is our third important operation is roguing of seed field. How you are going to rogue out the seed haptype plants? Roguing nothing but removal of the haptypes. Haptype means what is that? Plants differ in character as that of the seed variety. So there may be a difference in the leaf shape. There may be different in the color of the flower. There may be different in the shape of the fruit. So based on that, you have to remove the haptype plants. Third is voluntary plants. Sometimes what happened in tomato, suppose if you apply FOM, there will be a chances of getting a tomato seeds in FOM itself. That is a voluntary plant. It is come up through while putting FOM, it will come tomatoes, other tomato varieties. That tomato variety, that is a voluntary plant that has to be removed. So third is the diseased plant. Suppose if you find any disease, there is a specific diseases are there. Those diseased plants need to be removed. The pollen shedders and removal of the all these plants, you have to do before pollination, you have to remove all the haptype plants. This is an important operation that is a roguing. So roguing has to be carried out before pollination. So in order to get genetically pure seed or prototype seeds. So this is what are the maximum as per the seed act, they give us some percentage, the permissible limit. Suppose if your tomato variety is, if you have 1000 numbers of, suppose if you are sampling, you have to take out of that, if you have planted it 1000 numbers, 1000 plant means in that 10 plants should be differed from the undeserved plants. That means 0.1% is the permissible percent it can allow for foundation seeds. Similarly, all tomato is 0.1%. All tomato, okra, capsicum, brinjal, legumes, cucurbits, onion, carrot, radish, amaranthus, all 0.1% is allowable for haptype plants in foundation seed. Whereas in certified seeds, 0.2%. is allowable only for maximum allowable limit for considering the certified seed class. So I told you what are the designated diseases. What is the so some of the I told you have to rogue disease plants. Different crops are different designated diseases. See, this is a cabbage, cauliflower and noel coal. So black leg is one of the diseases. If you find out any disease, black leg or black rot, leaf spot, pilori, as spot, you have to remove from the seed plant. So similarly, cluster bean and alicus. Suppose if you find diseases like anthracnose, ascocyte blight or bacterial blight, those plant has to be removed. So in order to get good quality seeds. So in order to avoid, second thing is seed borne pathogens. Third is cowpea. Cowpea means these are the designated diseases like anthracnose, ascocyte blight, seed stem and blight and mosaic. Suppose if you find any type of these diseases, you have to uproot and throw away. similarly in case of french bean means anthracnose bacterial blight and bee mosaic. So in case of garden pea mosaic, that is important diseases. It will, if you leave it like, if you harvest from the pea mosaic, means definitely will get during the next crop. Those infected diseases plant has to be removed. Similarly, cucurbits means mosaic virus, all these diseases plant have to be removed. In case of brinjal, so you have seen very little leaf and pomaceous blight, these diseased plant has to be removed. In case of tomato, if you find any early blight or leaf spot or tobacco mosaic virus, if you find any this type of diseases, you have to be removed from the seed plant. So similarly in case of bendi, yellow vine mosaic virus, that is one of the virus diseases. It will spread easily that's what you have to, if you find any this type of the virus infected plants, means you have to uproot and remove, uproot from the seed plant. So similarly in case of what are the different objectionable weeds, so if you find any this type of weed, in case of cucurbits, wild cucurbit species, if you find any of this is one of the objectionable weed that has to be removed. In case of okra also, abelomuscus species, one of the wild species, will come across during the seed production. If you find those species, you have to remove from this main seed plant. So after that, you are going for harvest and post harvest practices. So after that, so you have to harvest the fruits at appropriate stage. So you have to harvest at the proper stage, so that you will get matured seed material. Otherwise, you will get improved or matured embryo. Hello. After that, so you have to transportation of the material through the processing unit. You have to take all the seed material, what after harvesting of the seed material, you have to bring it to the processing unit. Then you have to adopt the advanced technique for extraction of seed or seed processing material. Then you can go for testing of the seed sample. And verification of the seed standards, and fourth one is a grow out test to verify the true to type and check the seed borne diseases. These are all the harvest and post harvest practices. So these are the seed standards in vegetable. What are the seed? These are the different seed standard, like germination, purity of the seeds, what is the percentage of the inert material, what is the other crop should be there in the each and every crop, what is the maximum limit for the weed seeds, what is the moisture percentage in the ordinary pack, what is the moisture percentage in the effer group pack. So in tomato, that if your seed material is a foundation seed, means minimum germination you have to maintain 70%, and genetic purity is the 98%. Then inert material is a 2%. Whatever other crop seed means, so 5 numbers per kg of is allowable in tomato into for the foundation seeds. So whereas about say for the certified seeds, only 10 number of seeds per kg other crop seed is allowable. So weed seed should not be there in the tomato for both foundation and CS means certified seeds. So what is the moisture percentage per ad? If you pack ordinary pack, means you have to maintain minimum of 8% of the moisture, seed moisture. So if your packing material upper group, means you have to maintain the 6% moisture. Similarly, in case of brinjal, you have to maintain 70% both FS and CS, and pure seeds is 98%, and inert material is 2%. So other crops should not be there in brinjal, and weed seed should not be there. So you have to maintain the 8% of seed moisture and 6% in the upper group packet. These are all their chili, cabbage, cauliflower, radish, carrot, beetroot. This is a table. This is as per the Seed Act. As per the Seed Act, you have to maintain the standards for different crops. So similarly in cucurbits, so you have to maintain the foundation seeds, means you have to maintain the germination is 60%. If it is not there, means you should not sell the seed material. So you have to again go for processing, you have to improve over that seed material. So second one is how to maintain the pure seed, means you have to maintain 98% of the purity of this of that seed lot. So 2% is allowable for inert material. So remaining thing, what is that percentage of the soil moisture should be for ordinary pack, means 7% you have to maintain both foundation and certified seeds. Whereas effortproof pack is you have to maintain 6% as of seed moisture you have to maintain. This is all seed standard you have to follow all vegetable crops. This once you have produced the seed in the field, you have to go for certification. We have to done certification. So this certification is done by the one member from the National Seed Corporation, one member from State Seed Certification Agency, but breeder and one production officer has to see. This is what the picture you are seeing. So breeder is there for chili. So production from one officer from NSC, one officer from KSSOCA, Karnataka State Seed Corporation Organic Certification Agency. They will come and check that variety, whether the seed plot maintained purity or not. If they are maintaining purity, then only they will give labels. Otherwise, they will not give any certificate or any labels. That's what you have to maintain genetic purity of the commercial seed plot. So to make available true to type seed to the user, then only you'll get the user will get good benefits. So then routine visit by the qualified and experienced person from the certification agency at different stages of crop. So this is all about what I told now as of now, that is OPC production, open pollinated seed production. Now this is, I'm going to cover hybrid seed production, how we are going to do hybrid seed production. So before going to hybrid seed production, some of the important points to be considered. So what is that important points means? First one is anthesis. What is the meaning of anthesis? What is the meaning of emasculation? What is the meaning of pollination? What is the meaning of manual crossing? These are the important factors to be considered. You have to learn. So anthesis is nothing but the period during which flower is fully open and flower becomes sexually functional. So, and anthesis refers to a series of events between the opening and closing of the spikelets. That is nothing but anthesis you can call. Emasculation means removal of the male flower. So, male flower nothing but the stamens or anthers. Sometimes killing of the pollens of the flowers without damaging the female productive organ. That is called as emasculation. So pollination, what is meant by pollination? The movement of the pollen from the anther to the stigma by wind. So female stigma is essentially required for seed set and therefore crucial in the seed production. So, so what is a manual crossing? In case of hybrid seed production, pollens transfer from male parent anther to female stigma manually. So it is usually followed in the chili, tomato and okra. So I will explain so one by one what are the seed production, how we are carrying in tomato, chili, all the crops, how we are doing. I will explain next slides. So what is the advantage of the hybrids in general? So hybrids, what you will get benefits from the hybrids means you will get definitely productivity. You can increase the yield per unit area. Second important advantage is earliness. You can harvest the crop in early stage, within short duration. That is one of the important advantages of the hybrid. Third advantage, you can get uniformity of the produce. Fourth advantage is the quality. So you can get good quality of produce. Then fifth is you'll get the variety, you can get the seed material which are resistant to pest and diseases. So finally, what higher prices for the seed producer will get. These are the important advantages of the hybrids. So first, I am going to tell seed production in tomato. So in tomato, we are going to see carried out. So production foundation seeds, you are maintaining 50 meter of isolation distance. There is a two important, I told you earlier slides. So for two isolation distance has to be maintained, and roguing operation is very important. Two factors has to maintain for the production of any vegetable seed production. So for foundation seeds, you have to maintain 50 meter of isolation distance. On certified seeds, you have to maintain 25 meter of distance. For breeder seed production, so you maintain, you have to maintain 200 meter of isolation distance, so that you can avoid the contamination with the other plants, other pollens of the plant. So second operation is the roguing. So when you have to do roguing operation, so roguing operation has to do at three stages. One at vegetative stage. How you are going to do in vegetative stage means on the basis of the foliage character, so that the shape of the leaf, so he can judge the whether the desirable character or undesirable character, he can judge during the vegetative stage. Second stage of roguing is during the flowering and fruiting stage. So how you are doing based on the character of the fruits, the shape of the fruit, size of the fruit, suppose shape of the color of the fruit. So suppose if you affected any seed borne disease, means you have to uproot and you have to rogue out those plants. This is done during the flowering or fruiting stage. Third important roguing operation any you have to do means maturity fruiting stage. So at that time, you can color and shape of the fruit, you can based on that you can rogue out the plant. So the third important harvesting. So when you have to harvest these, I told you that the harvesting has to be done during the physiological maturity. Suppose if your fruit is fully red ripe, then only you have to harvest the seed. Otherwise, if you harvested before immature fruits, means definitely will get immature seed material, will not get matured well. In that, you will not get any germination. There will be problem with germination percentage, germination. Okay. This is all about harvesting. Once you harvest this fruit, tomato fruits, how you are going to extract the seed material? So there is a two method of extraction of seed material, seed extraction in tomato. One is fermentation method. Then you have to, second is acid treatment method. In fermentation method, you have to, there is a seed extraction machine. So in that you have to extract the pulp and seed material separately and allow it for fermentation for 48 hours. Then you have to wash it through running tap water. Second is acid treatment method. So different acid treatment. This is a dilute acid treatment, that is a sodium carbonate, or using a separation with HCl. You can, based on that, you can extract the seed from the tomato pulp. Okay, this is a different extraction method. So what is the seed yield you will get? Suppose if your tomato is, if your fruit is 1 ton, means definitely you will get 10 kg of seed material. This is a seed production in tomato. So this is, see, I'm showing the picture. How this is a emasculation procedure. This is you have to select the flower bud. This is the right stage of selection of flower, first photo what I am showing here. This is a selection of flower bud. This is the removal of male flower, anthers. How you are, this is a hemasculation. See, this is, is going to be remove the male flower. So this is a emasculated flower. See, is removed. This is how you are going to the emasculation in tomato. This is only the stigma ill remaining in the flower bud. Remaining stamens, whatever the stamens present in the flower, they will remove. That is a removal of the male part. That is called as a emasculation. You are doing that emasculation. After emasculation, what they are doing? So this is a pollen from the male parent. See, this first photo, what I'm showing, they will collect the flower previous day, then allow it for bursting. So see, this is a pack. They will harvest one day prior. After that, they will put it in the white cover, then dry anther for 24 hours at 30 degree centigrade. In that they will collect the pollens. See, this is the third photo. What I am showing is dry anthers for 24 hours at 30 degree centigrade. After that they will collect the pollens through mesh. They will that powder form will come. That is nothing but a pollens. They will collect it in the different different container. Okay, this is a collection of pollen. How they are collection? So this is a series of procedure you have to follow for hybrid production in tomato. So this is once you have collected the pollens, so you have to be manual crossing is required. So collected pollen has to be crossed with the emasculated flowers. This is a see what I already emasculated flower is there with you. This is a pollen. Second photo is a pollen collected in the one container. Then you have to put it in the pollen. That is a crossing. This is called as a crossing, manual crossing. We call it. So once you cross it means you have to make a tag of that each and every bud. This is how we are going to do in tomato hybrid seed production. So this is how they are doing in tomato hybrid seed production in Ranebennur. See, people are so many technical people are doing emasculation crossing in morning time also. Once they doing after completion of the pollination, they go for this is the second photo is a seed set. That is a pollinator seeds after pollination the seed will set like this. Okay, second photo. So similar, this is second is a chili hybrid seed production. So raising up male and female parents. So you have to raise the male parent 7 to 10 days prior to the female parent. So you have to raise female male parent earlier 7 to 10 days early. What is the ratio you have to follow means? So female is 4 and male is 1. You have to 4:1 ratio you have to follow female and male ratio. So third operation is roguing. Roguing you have to do before flowering on the basis of the growth, particularly leaf size. In chili means so based on the leaf size you have to remove the haptite. So second roguing operation during the early flowering or first fruit maturing, that is based on the shape and color of the fruit. Third one based on the shape of the
sorry for the interruption, some technical issues are there from the speaker side.
Dr. Dhananjay,
Sir, just we have contacted speaker, sir. Some technical issues are there. Within 2 minutes, he will be joining, sir. Joining back.
Okay.
Sir, just share your screen, sir.
ಅದೇ ಆನ್ ಮಾಡಿದಿರಲ್ಲ
ಅನ್ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಅಂತ ಪಾಸ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಹಾಕಿದ್ರೆ
ಪಾಸ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಹಾಕಿದ್ರೆ
ಇಲ್ಲ ಕೋಸ್ಟ್
ಇರ್ಲೇ ಬಿಡ್ರಿ ನೋಡೋಣ ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸಾರಿ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬೆನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಐ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ ಹೈಬ್ರಿಡ್ ಸೀಡ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೇಲ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಇಸ್ 4:1. ಸೊ ರೋಗಿಂಗ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡನ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ಲವರಿಂಗ್, ಅರ್ಲಿ ಫ್ಲವರಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ರೂಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ದ ಐಸೋಲೇಷನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ so when you have to harvest these seed material, means when the seed and the fruits turn in the red color, then only you have to harvest this seed. How to do the extraction, means you have to, there is a extraction of there is a machine is with the help of the seed extraction, means you can extract the seed material. So you can, depending of the variety seed, will vary from 3 to 5 quintal per hectare. So this is a emasculation technique in chili. See, this is a flower bud you have to select. After that, you have to remove the anthers. That is a male flower you have to remove. So you have to hollow it for the stigma. This is a emasculation technique in chili, similar to as that of the tomato. So this, once you have to emasculated, you have to go for crossing with our pollens. This is a, say, this is a emasculated flower. After that, you have to go for pollination. So once the collected pollens, you have to make for pollination. Then you go for tagging. So why you are going to make a tagging, means you have to, that means if you made a tag, means that is a cross, that is a crossed one. So this is a, see, one that is a person, he has done all the crossing per plant, how many fruits he has made a pollinated. So then he made the all the, have you seen these three threads, different threads, how many threads you have made? That is, means if you made a thread, means that is a pollinated bud. So this is the one he can, what you are seeing is this is a machine called as a seed extraction, chili seed extraction. From this you can extract chili, tomato and brinjal. So these that pulp, this is a seed, what I am showing here is a, so this is a seed material, it will come one side, that is a pulp is a come one side. This is a extraction machine, you can extract the seed material easily through. Earlier what you are doing is manual extraction was there. Now with the help of the seed extraction machine, you are extracting the seed material. So this is similarly in case of foundation seeds. So foundation means brinjal, for foundation seed production required 100 meter and certified seeds is 150 meter. And how different rows rated, that is the standard method. So you have to do one at before flowering and fruiting stage based on the fruiting habit and based on the shape of the and color of the fruit, and the fourth one is during the fruiting stage. So how you are doing seed extraction in brinjal means with seed extraction method, that is what you are seeing. This is a machine you are calling it the seed extraction machine. This is what, this is a yellow color one, this is a big, they are extracting the seed material. See, this is a pulp, this is what you are seeing here means. So seed is extracted from this machine. So what is expected yield from 1 acre means one, so you can expect 150 to 200 kg per hectare. This is seed production in okra. So foundation seed means 500, certified seeds 250, and breeder seed is 500 meter is required. So the okra, so roguing operation, I told you that yellow vine mazak virus disease plant has to be removed if you observe during the any stage of the crop. So that has to be removed, so in order to maintain the genetic purity of the crop. So when you have to harvest the fruits means completely dry, the seed will not get germinated. So what is the expected yield you can get means 10 to 15 quintals per hectare you can expect the seed yield from the okra. So see, this is a white plant, that is a major problem. So that itself, it will transfer the YVMU symptoms. This is a C. This is a yellow color. So what you photo you are showing, this is a yellow vein mojaca virus symptoms. This is a early leaf curl virus symptoms. This whatever I am showing, this is a photos. So this is transported by the white plant. These, if you find these two type of plants in your seed plant in okra means you have to remove immediately and throw away. So this is a bendy seed production, hybrid seed production in bendy. So this is a method, emasculation technique in bendy. See, this is, they will remove the anthers, that is a male flower they are removing. This is a seed, the seeds removing anther male flower in this photo. So the after removing of the male flowers, so they were going to be crossed with our pollens, then make it at they will cover it with a paper. See, this is a fourth photo after putting the pollens, they will cover it with the paper cover and then make it a tag. Okay, so this is a, see, this is a bendy flower. So before anthesis, so before pollination, so this is after and a day after anthesis. See, after anthesis, see the, what are the powder parameter, see the powder param we can our. So before anthesis, this is a flower bud of okra. So this is a one of the variety you have developed in IHR, that male sterile flower. So emasculation of each and emasculation of you have to do emasculation. So instead of doing emasculation, so the plant itself will get the male sterile flower. So that is one of the variety you have, that is advanced method of technology you have developed in at IHR, that is a GMS line, what you call it is GMS line at IHR. That is one variety named as Arka Nikita. So there you need not to require any emasculation method. So this is a monitoring team, so for getting our certification or labeling. So these are the different corporation and state certification agency. This is the fruit of bendy. So this is a seed production plant only. So see how we have to maintain the purity, everything. You should be uniform in other aspect, whether it is a leaf character, whether it is a fruit character, whether it is a flower character, you have to maintain minimum uniformity in the seed production plants. So this is a harvesting the pod harvesting stage. See, the pod should be like this, then only you have to harvest this time during this period. This is see the ones after harvesting of the seed material, the seed with good quality seed material. This is a material. So just I am after getting, we'll get both quality of material with good and low quality. You have to separate from the through processing. That is a different processing method. So this is cucurbits. So how we are doing in seed production practices in cucurbits. So this is a different isolation practices you have to maintain. Certified seed means 400 meter, foundation seed means 800, and breeder seed production means 1000 meter you have to follow. Rogging same as usual. So during flowering, during fruit set, fruiting stage, you have to remove all the up types. When you have to harvest, that is important parameter. Maturity indices in means color changes yellow to yellow orange, harvest for seed purpose. Otherwise the seed matured. So how we have to get it? By seed extraction, by manual seed extraction only, or mechanical also you can done. So what is the expected yield, seed yield means 500 to 1000 seed kg you can expect from 1 hectare of seed material. So this is different cucurbits like Ridge guard, pumpkin, and bottle guard. These are the cucurbits. So I am taken into consideration. This is a hybrid seed production in cucurbits. This is a female flower. This is a male flower. After that, so this is a bagged or self female flower. See, with cross the flower. Then this is the pollination. This is the method. Already I shown you in tomato, brinjal, and chili. Same procedure you are following in the ridge guard also. So this is after seed crossing of that fruit will come like this. So okay, so this is in case of watermelon. So watermelon, this is a male parent. So this is a female parent. So after that you have to plant 1:4 for every one row of male. So there should be a four line of female plant you have to be follow. So this is a male flower blood. So you have to, one day before you have to collect the male flower. So you have to keep it in the with a temperature of 30 degrees centigrade. Then you will drill that. From that you can collect the pollens next day. You can, okay. So after getting the collection of a pollen, you have to cross with the female flower. Okay. So this is emasculated. This is a flower. After crossing with, you have to make a tagging with the cover with the paper. So this is a fruit set after crossing. This is one of in watermelon. So after that, this is a due shooting in a watermelon. So after the for watermelon, for each vine, only one fruit has to be hollow. So it should not be more than one fruit. So the for that they are going for due shooting in watermelon. Otherwise, seed quality will not be good. So this is removing of the rogging of the half type plot in seed production. See, the how he is removing based on the fruit character, he is removing the half type by the farmer. So this is a farmer seed production plot in Sira taluk. How he has maintained seed production plot in Sira taluk farmer. So I visited myself and the breeder has visited seed production plot in watermelon seed production plot in Sira taluk. So he has maintained all the 100% genetic purity of the crop. So then you have removed half type also. So you have inspected everything in the seed production. This is seed production. Certified seed production 500 meter. This is Hania seed production practices. Certified means 500 meter is required. Foundation seed means 1000 meters, and breeder seed production means 1000 meter isolation is required. So rogging operation is very important. So 30 to 40 days after planting, you have to here bulk crop production is a two season is required. One season is exclusive for bulk seed production. Second season for seed production. Any onion seed production is required 2 season. Okay, first season for bulk seed production, second is for seed production. So this is how you are going to, this is our rogging operation you have to do at different stages when the bulbs are lifted. At the time of bulb replanting also you have to do rogging operation. At the time of the flowering also you have to rog out the up type plants. So how that harvesting and seed has to be done is done when the heads are some capsule with black color will open. So some humble, if you see the humble means, so you can see the a black color capsule. So at that time you have to harvest the cut the humbug or go to 6 inches below the stem, then extraction seed extraction by the threshing. What is the expected seed yield is 600 to 800 kg per hectare. This is a selection of our grading up the bulb. These this type of the onion bulb is required for planting. So see after that 1/4 of the bulb is going to be cut. So in order to better germination and better growth, so after that she is going to plant like this. See, so this lady is going to plant so with per each and every day. So this is a after planting the bulb, she will get like this flower. So what he is seeing, this farmer is grown this onion seed production. Okay. This is all regarding with rails leafy vegetables. So third one is the seed production in leafy vegetables. The boundary, sorry, this is a legumes. Isolation distance is required 50 meters. This is a certified means 25 meter is required. So when you have to rob out before flowering, at flowering is required. So at maturity, late flowering and mature off type easily detected. So part development stage based on the part shape, size, color and seed borne diseases you have to remove during the important diseases like I already I given the table, the anthracnose, bacterial blight, mosaic plants has to be removed during the seed production of French bean. So this is a first photo what I am showing. This is a French bean seed production plants. So this is the second photo is showing that Dalika seed production. Third photo is a handling seed production. These are all legumes. So based well, legume OP pollinated. This is the much this is a French bean Arca severa seed production plant in our IHR plant. This is how the seed plants seeds are looking uniformity. So this is a half type is removing this. Suppose if you find any half type in the particular plant, means you have to remove those half type. So you have to maintain the purity of the seed plant. Yeah, sorry. So this is with respect to when to harvest. So during the ripening stage, irrigation has to be stopped. So legume crops. Part turned yellow color, maybe you have to maybe ready for shutters. Seed threshed manually. How you are the extraction of seeds in the legumes? Means you have to thresh manually or mechanically. You can extract the seed material. So one should be care should be taken. Any legumes are susceptible to cracking. So the one care should be taken during the threshing. So once it is threshed, means you have to seeds are available to 2 to 3 years. So you can expect in any legumes. So seed yield around 12 to 18 quintals per hectare. So with respect to the root crops, in root crop means radish. So particularly I am telling for radish, there is a two method of seed production. One is root to seed method. Second one is seed to seed method. So in root to seed method, what you are doing, first you will allow it for production of root roots. Then you will select the roots, best root. So after that, you will plant these roots for seed production. Second method is seed to seed. Then if you plant, you will sow the seed material, you allow it for the seed production. Without uprooting the root and select the root, again, you will not go into plant these. This is the seed to seed method. What is the minimum isolation is required is 1,600 meters for foundation seed. Breeder seeds, similar 1,600 meters is required. For certified seeds, 1,000 meters is required. So you have to rub out all the half type plants during vegetative stage and flowering stage and fruiting stage. So when you have to harvest, that harvesting indices means the parts are allowed to mature in the prime and ripe. So the parts become the brown color, then only you can harvest the radish seeds. What is the expected yield? Seed yield you can expect 400 to 600 kg per hectare. So this is how we are going to, this is a first method, that is a root to seed method. First you grown for roots. So these three people are selecting the roots of very good quality of seeds. Then they will cut it. So they will see what is the, whether the pithiness is there. If pithiness is there, means you should not take that. The pithiness should be tight. So you have to select the good one after selection of. So see, this is like this of the root should be like this. So then after that, you have to select like this roots. After selection of the roots, you have to dip into the potassium permanganate solution in order to the fungal growth, in order to fungal growth, is they will dipping into potassium permanganate solution. Then these are all is going to be then you can plant into the according to spacing you can plant. So then you can hollow it for the flowering. This is one of the method you can follow in the radish seed production. So with respect to the leafy vegetables, so all leafy vegetables, green amaranth, red amaranth, spalak, how you are going to do seed production means. So first one is isolation distance. You have to maintain 400 meters for foundation seeds and 200 meter for certified seeds, and 400 meter is required for breeder seed production. So two inspection is required during vegetative stage and follow the flowering stage. So during that stage only, whatever the haplotype present in the amaranthus, that those haplotype plants you have to row, especially during amaranthus, that is wild amaranthus species. So you can observe those amaranthus you have to that is a wild species, that is old species, has to be removed in order to maintain the purity of the seed plant. What is the expected? You can expect 800 to 1000 kg per hectare seed yield. So once you harvest the seed material, these are the you will get very good quality seeds. The quality seeds are thing, but you have to maintain the minimum germination percentage. I already given them the table, what is the percentage you maintain for each and every crop. So this is a germination percentage has to be recorded. Once you get good quality germination, you got it, means definitely you will get good result with good successful crop production. So thank you very much. So if anybody having any questions, please
thank you Dr. Nagegowda sir for giving such an elaborate presentation on vegetable seed production.
Sir, your voice is not audible.
Hello sir.
No,
is it audible sir?
Not audible sir.
Yeah, I have a question sir.
Dr. Nagegowda, you please on your speakers, maybe
this, this is Dr. Sabina sir. I have a question.
Yeah, somebody is asking question.
Sir, Nagegowda, actually
on your
the speaker, seed
you're not able to the, listen.
Sir, hybrid seed production is nowadays in vogue, but in these solanaceous groups it's quite difficult to make the hybrids manually by doing emasculation and all that. Do we have any CMS lines in tomato and chilies where we can use them for mass scale hybridization and so thereby reducing the cost of the hybrid seeds?
Anagide sir.
Ah, yes sir.
Madam, repeat.
Can you hear me sir?
Yes sir, it is audible sir.
Sir, I have asked one question sir. I have a question.
Wait until.
Madam, just a minute madam. Sir, actually he is having some technical issues.
Am I audible sir?
You are audible very much.
Yeah, I just want to ask one question. Hello.
You can speak, but Dr. Nagegowda is able to hear it or not?
Yeah, sir. The hybrid seed production is in vogue these days, but the process of making hybrids in these solanaceous crops is quite difficult. By using manual means. Do we have any CMS lines? In
sir, you can now we can ask any question, sir. Please.
Sir, now is it audible, sir?
Now it is audible, sir.
Madam, can you please just repeat your question once again?
The emasculation and doing hybridization manually is quite difficult, you know.
Emasculation.
Because of the size of the flower, it's too small, and so it becomes quite difficult. Do we have any CMS lines in
chili? It is just CGMS lines are available there itself, not required any emasculation. In bendy also is not required. That is a genetic. Already I told you on slide, I show you na, that is a genetic male sterile. For that, there is no not required any emasculation.
Yes, sir. So do we use the employ these CMS lines for mass scale production of hybrids?
Yeah, you can use, madam.
So is there any success story regarding the usage
yeah,
of
yeah,
these
yeah.
lines?
Yeah, yeah. So what you are doing, Miss, CMS lines only you are doing in Chile. And also in GMS, Gentic Male Sterile, in Bendy also your large scale, your production in large scale also. Last time you did it in large scale.
Okay, so the what about
got
the
it, madam?
Yeah, do you produce seed of these lines yourself or you do it through the farmers?
Yeah, 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 through farmer only, you are doing. Not in IHR itself, you are doing outside the IHR. So in Ranebennuru and Haveri, there is a place, there are doing there itself, okay.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you,
sir. Oh, welcome.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, tell
me. Sir, this is Mahantesh. Sir, you are yeah. using the mechanical threshers for seed collection.
Pardon, sir?
What? You are using the, some
Your
of the mechanical...
Breaking, sir.
Hello, sir. Is it audible now?
Huh.
Is it audible, sir?
Your bandwidth is low. Your voice is breaking.
Okay, maybe network problem from my side. Maybe. Hello?
Hello, maybe.
Network problem from my side, I think.
Yeah, our network is good. No problem.
From my
you can give me a chat box also. I will answer part of the question.
Sir, Mantesh Naik, sir, some technical issues are there. Sir,
sir hello. I'll text in the chat box.
Yeah, Jagdish. Hello.
Dr. Nagegowda, there is no net issues. You are also audible and Dr. Mantesh is also audible. Only thing is your speakers, some loose connection is there, it seems. That's why you are not able to hear it.
Sometimes it is audible. Now your voice is audible, sir.
The thing is, it is not the net issue. It is the speaker, the pin you are using may be having some issue. Please check it out. At your end. Otherwise, both of you are audible to us. That means there is no issue of net. At IHR and also
now it is audible, sir. Now there is no issue of audible.
Dr. Mantesh, you can just ask now.
Dr. Mantesh Naik, sir, are you there? Sir, it seems some issues are there from Mantesh Naik's side soon.
Just proceed to some other questions.
Okay, good evening, sir. This is Devita Kumari from Chennai, sir. For your class was very useful and more informative, sir. Regarding this, sir, this for mint and all, after mint. After using the top portion, we will keep the root portion. It will come, sir.
Pardon, madam?
But coriander leaves, no?
Okay.
Shall we put the bottom, that root, or we have to put the seed for coriander cultivation, sir?
Coriander leaves?
Coriander root, no? Can
Roots,
we
put okay.
that? Or the coriander seeds to get the okay. coriander plant in home?
Madam, coriander, it is not like radish.
Sir, anyone can
need to seed only how to do it. I think Dr. Nagegowda, you are not able to listen to her. Madam, it is seed you have to plant and you have to get the seeds directly. Seed to seed only. No question of replanting or root or anything there.
Okay, only seed. Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Hello? Hello.
If you are there from participant side, please post it in chat box. We shall communicate it to the speaker because in line we are having another lecture from Dr. Vidyadhar Bonta on vegetable seed production in protected cultivation and overview. So we are running out of time.
One last question.
Sir, actually that speaker is having some technical issues, sir. Just you type it in the chat box, sir. We shall communicate it to speaker.
Sir, now it is audible. You can ask any question, sir, please.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah, now yeah. Okay.
Ravindra Mulge.
Dr. VT Egde. Please.
Ravindra Mulge, good evening. Maybe you can recollect me. Yeah, I am also working in a Nunam Seeds, a private company. Maybe you are also once upon a time my colleague in ProAgro. Maybe just an introduction.
Yes. Yes, Dr. Hegde, if you have got anything to ask, Dr. Nagegowda, please.
Yeah, good. And it is regarding the advanced seed production.
Others, please mute.
Advanced seed production in vegetables, where the private company like Nunhams, I'm working for the Nunhams. We are also in a very, very good advanced technology, like use of pollen and also the insect pollination in hybrid seed production and disease-free seed production. There are many areas in vegetable seed production we are far ahead and also learning from many advanced countries like Israel, Thailand, and Netherlands. Maybe my question or suggestion is maybe some sort of collaboration with private is very much needed. Maybe how far you are looking, and also whether it can be an opportunity to win-win situation, and we can learn from each other and explore and make the India as a hub of. That is my question. Yeah, that is my suggestion. Public partnership, public-private partnership, and exploring the new opportunities, considering the private company as also a good partner.
Yeah, that's a good suggestion, Dr. Hegde. But Dr. Nagegowda is a technical officer there. I think some higher ups can be involved in such discussions, definitely to have a collaboration. Are you there? You want to react to this? You may be having, because they are now, what they are doing, AHR, they are auctioning their some of the hybrids and giving it to the private people. But the seed production, I don't think they are having any collaboration. But of course, they are tagging with some of the farmers and they are producing the seeds. But the hybrids, they are giving out to some of the companies. They are auctioning and selling it. Dr. Nagegowda, can you react? Or I think some.
Sir, Nagegowda sir is not there, sir. Actually, technical issues has already.
Yeah, Dr. Nagegowda, that is the status. I think it is between the directors and the higher ups can put these things. The proceedings are in the this training. We can give a feedback and we can write to the director of IHR also regarding this. Okay.
Thank you so much, sir. On behalf of University of Horticulture Sciences Bagalkot and College of Horticulture Bidar, I extend my sincere thanks to Dr. Nagegowda sir for giving a nice presentation. Next, may call upon Dr. Vidyadhar Bonta, Professor, College of Agriculture, Warangal, to give lecture on vegetable seed production in protected cultivation and overview. Sir Bonta sir, are you there?
Yeah.
Sir, kindly share your slide, sir.
Dhananjay sir, aur bagi heli on salpa explain madi.
Ah, sir.
Dhananjay sir.
Yes, sir.
Aur bagi on salpa explain madi ala matte.
Sir, may invite Dr. Ashok Suryavanshi sir to give brief introduction about Dr. Vidyadhar Bonta, Professor, College of Agriculture, Warangal. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Dhananjay. Good afternoon to all the participants. Very happy to introduce today's speaker, Dr. Vidyadhar Bonta. He is working as a professor seed technology at Agriculture College, Warangal. He did his MSc seed technology from Angro, Hyderabad, and later he joined PhD in IRI and worked on effect of plant growth, seed yield, and quality attribute of cherry tomato grown under different product